Hi, I'm Cable from Panic, and we make super nice apps for iPhones and iPads and Macs. Well, once upon a time, we started hearing a frequent complaint from our customers. Your app downloads are really slow. We realized that even for all of us at home, our downloads really were slow. Borderline dial-up slow. We roll our own web servers with a single connection from Cogent. And after checking and rechecking every conceivable config file 1,000 times, we did what any self-respecting dork nerd app-making company would do. We wrote a test script. It downloaded 20 megs from our server, and then downloaded 20 megs from a Linode control server. By recording the download times and the user's ISP, we could see if there was any pattern to this madness. About 1,000 of our users ran the test, we charted the results, and yipee-dipee, it didn't take long to see the problem. Everybody had solid speeds to us, except for Comcast users. And this is when I learned all about peering. Let me explain. So all the major internet carriers have peering agreements between them. These are mutually beneficial contracts between companies that say, hey, we're gonna send your data to our customers, and you're gonna send your data back to us. Everybody has to bear the load for everybody else. It's how it all works. Then I learned that Comcast and Cogent have a particularly contentious history with peering. Once Cogent started delivering a ton of Netflix data, Comcast pipe to Cogent mysteriously clogged, and they refused to fix it. If you Google Comcast versus Cogent, you'll see what I'm talking about. They don't like each other very much. There was congressional testimony and everything. So we were sure this was happening again. Comcast pipe to Cogent was getting saturated during peak times, and it was tough beans all around. There would be no way to fix it. We were stuck in the middle of a classic corporate kerfuffle. But then something really weird happened. I wrote Comcast an email. Not a support email, because a person can only reboot their router so many times. No, I went the corporate route and I found a public-facing person involved in Comcast network operations. And you might not believe this, but they took me seriously. They reached out to their team of people, they asked me to help connect them with a peering contact at Cogent, they took a few days to research, and then they called back with a fascinating statement, try it again in 1 or 2 weeks, and I think you'll be happy. Well, sure enough, we had everyone rerun our test script about a month later, and it was perfect. Comcast downloads to Cogent were now fast. Problem solved, we did it! But I'd be lying if I didn't feel a little suspicious about this. It doesn't feel right, right? Why wasn't this fixed proactively before I sent my dumb email? Why did Cogent think nothing could be done? What would make Comcast fix this problem for randos like us? But I can only get so weirded out because, hey, our Comcast customers can download our apps fast again. And I have to give real credit to Comcast for actually listening to us and fixing the problem. Maybe I'm just being too cynical. Or maybe not. Anyway, that's case closed on the mystery of the slow downloads. And an important reminder that the internet we all rely on every single day is actually really fragile. Good luck, internet.